What's up guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new to my channel then welcome. My name is Meghna. Today's video is a very casual video. Like you can see, I'm literally wearing like ghar ke kapde. I'm even shooting on my phone, so it's very chill vibes. Okay, I wanted to talk about journaling because that's a question I keep getting asked in my DMs and in my comments. I've mentioned journaling many times on my channel, and I think some of you are new to all of this, just seem to be wondering like what journaling means and how is it different from using a planner. And I'll also be touching upon some of the journals that I maintain and how I specifically do my gratitude journaling, since that's something again all of you really requested me to make a video on. So I will include all of that in this video. Before getting into this video, if you haven't already, please do subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of my future videos. And I do upload twice a week, every Wednesday and Saturday. It'll just be amazing to have more people in the Meg fam. So I hope you've subscribed. Now let's quickly get into this video. So I haven't scripted this video at all, okay? I'm literally just going to go with the flow and explain to you what firstly journaling means, right? Journaling essentially means putting down your thoughts and your feelings on a piece of paper, or nowadays you can even do it digitally on an app. Personally for me, I use traditional methods of using a pen and paper to journal my thoughts. I also use a digital journal which is called Reflectly. I have spoken a lot about it in my morning routine video, so if you haven't watched that, I will link it up here. Now if you followed my channel for a while, you know I use a planner as well, and I've also mentioned how I don't write the to-do list in the daily spread. In fact, I actually use it to journal. Now when I use the word journal, I mean that I use that section to just simply write down the highlights of my day. So it's more like the dear diary entries that, you know, hum school mein karte hai, jo main apne bachpan mein karti thi, you know, like dear diary, today school mein ye hua, teacher ne ye kaha, mujhe exams mein itne marks aaye, those sort of things. I would very briefly mention it in the daily section of my planner. So it's not necessarily talking about my feelings and what I think about life or why I feel so anxious about certain things. I'm not writing all of that in my planner, okay? That's for a separate space completely. And I did mention in my notebook collection video that I use this particular notebook by Daily Objects. I think even now they have some sale of buy one get one free. So these are essentially just empty blank pages. You can even have rule pages. There are no rules to journaling as such. There's nothing to explain in terms of how I personally journal my thoughts and feelings, because it's just free flowing thought, right? And I don't do it as a routine thing, which you can probably start doing if you're a completely beginner to journaling. You can do it like a daily or a weekly practice where you set some time aside to journal your thoughts and feelings of that day, of that week, and slowly you will see how it's actually going to benefit you in your life. So mainly when I'm feeling very anxious or stressed about certain things in my life or certain areas of my life, that's when I pick this book and I literally just word vomit. Like I write everything and anything in this without any filter. Sometimes when I literally go back and read some of the pages, I'm like, wow Meghna, like you thought all of that. But that's the beauty of journaling. Like it's unfiltered, it's completely raw, and it's just for you. You're not going to advertise this to anyone unless you want to, and it's a completely judgment-free zone to me, and that's how it should be for you as well. You can't judge yourself while journaling. It is just your free-flowing thoughts. You're letting your feelings and thoughts onto a piece of paper, or if you're doing it digitally. So yeah, for me, I just mentioned the date and the time and I just word vomit and write all my free-flowing thoughts and feelings. But yeah, I've realized that this has helped me so much. I immediately feel better after journaling my thoughts and feelings, because sometimes most of these stressors are just small things that are piled up in your head over a course of time, and you don't even realize it until it gets into that big lump in your head. So that's when you realize that after journaling, it's sort of unloading your brain and decluttering your mind, and it really works. It's scientifically proven it works. So anyone who does have anxiety or has just really stressful moments, or you're going through a bad phase and rough phase of your life, try journaling it out. I can assure you it can't do any harm for you. If anything, it will only do good for you, okay? So do give it a try. So yeah, first you can start out with journaling your thoughts and feelings as a habit of doing it daily or weekly. Another thing I can talk about my way of journaling, other than just pouring out my thoughts and feelings, I also end up sorting out my problems while journaling it out. Actually, let me take you to my first entry in this particular notebook. I remember being really stressed about, like, you know, what I want to do in life. I feel that's a very common question, especially for millennials right now, because we are in that age or that phase of life. So yeah, I remember just writing this, you know, I have no idea what to do in life, and there's so many options and so many things I like. I mean, I'm sure you can look at my channel and figure out that I'm so multi-passionate. So yeah, basically that same thing on a more severe degree was happening in my head, and I was so stressed and anxious, and I just wrote down all of those things. In that process, I just kept asking myself questions. One question I've asked myself is, if I had no way to fail at anything in life, what would I do for the rest of my life? I remember hearing this in one of the podcasts I was listening to at that point of time, and they had asked this question and it really hit me. If you had no way of failing at anything in life, what would you do for the rest of your life? And that really hit my brain, because many of the times the thing that is stopping us from achieving our dream life is fear. And you can right now pause this video and reflect upon why you feel that you are not reaching your goals. There will be some sort of fear hiding behind that excuse. So yeah, I asked myself that question and I answered it for myself, and I eventually actually figured out top three things that I really want to be doing in my life for the rest of my life as of now. So yeah, I came to a sort of conclusion and really cleared my brain. So while journaling my thoughts and feelings, I didn't have any preconceived expectation that, you know, yes, I'm going to sort out my life after journaling my thoughts. That was not in my head. I was just simply writing down my feelings inside this, and slowly I kept asking questions to myself. That's what you'd notice you would end up doing eventually while journaling, and that's why it's even more helpful, right? It's not just a way for you to declutter your mind, which is a very big part of it, by the way, but it also eventually helps you to sort out your life. I mean, who does not want that? Another tip I can give for anyone who's just starting out with journaling and you're still overwhelmed and you don't trust yourself to even, you know, start with that first line of putting your thoughts and feelings, because sometimes it does take courage to face our own deepest thoughts and feelings. Whatever my thoughts and feelings are, they don't define me. They're just a small part of me. And it's just a way for me to understand myself better and grow as a person. So don't judge yourself while journaling, firstly. Secondly, for anyone who's still clueless as to how you can start with journaling, just go on Pinterest and search journaling prompts. Thousands of amazing journaling prompts. You can just put that as a question daily in your journal and answer that for you. It could be a para answer, it could be like pages of answer. That's completely up to you. That's a very simple and even fun way to start with journaling your thoughts and feelings, by just answering certain journal prompts that you will find on Pinterest. So yeah, that was my insight on how I journal my thoughts and feelings, and that's what journaling essentially means. Now you know the difference between what I write in my planner and what I write in my journal. Now coming to gratitude journaling and how I go about it. So I have gone through multiple ways of gratitude journaling, but I will just speak about the way that's worked the best for me. So again, I just have a separate notebook for it. So every day I mention the date, I practice it daily, and I write down 5 things I'm grateful for that day. I started this off with 10 things, and I realized that I ended up looking at it as a task and I ended up not being consistently following that habit. So I just reduced those 10 things to 5 things, which is more doable for me. Maybe for you, you can start out with 10. I remember initially it was very like general things like, oh, I'm grateful for waking up today, or I'm grateful for the food I got today. Those are of course great things to be grateful for, but I feel it's way more effective and less monotonous when you are very specific about what you're grateful for in that day. So instead of saying I am grateful for the food I had today, because of course you are grateful for the food you had today, but every single day you're having food, and when you keep mentioning that again and again, it sort of becomes monotonous and you might tend to take it for granted even if you're writing I'm grateful for it. And it might just become a redundant practice that you're doing instead of actually feeling that feeling of gratitude. To avoid that completely, you can be specific. What was that one food that you really, really loved and you're genuinely grateful for it? So for me today, I had yummy fish curry. In my gratitude practice tonight, I'm going to write, thank you for the amazing fish curry that I had during lunch. You know, that is being specific. So that way you're writing different things every single day, but you're still being grateful for those small things, right? Another amazing thing that happens when you start doing it daily like this and being specific is that throughout the day, subconsciously or even consciously, you're looking for things that you can write in your gratitude journal that night. Once I started doing this, that's what happened with me. Like today when I had fish curry, I was thinking, wow, I love this so much. And then immediately I was like, oh, this is definitely going in my gratitude journal. Throughout the day, you are consciously or subconsciously seeing the things that are making you happy and you're grateful for. And you will realize there are more than 5 things. You start being happy about the small things, the daily mundane things, not just the big things, right? That is the point of this practice. We tend to take a lot of things for granted. So it's sort of rewiring your brain to be grateful for even the smallest of things. So instead of saying something very generic like I'm thankful for my health, which is great, how can you be more specific? I'm thankful that I could shoot 4 dance reels today because I have that sort of stamina, or my heart is able to do that. Be specific, number one. Number two, please give a reason. So I'm not just going to say thank you for the fish curry. I'm going to say I'm grateful for the fish curry I had during lunch because it was so khatta. Like, I mean, that's how I felt. So I'm going to write that. Or it was so spicy. Or because my mom took an extra half an hour to prepare it. Why are you grateful for that green tea that you had in the morning? Thank you for the green tea I had. It made me feel so warm and fuzzy inside. So that's giving a reason to the thing that you're grateful for. So I think that also really helps you feel genuinely grateful about the things that you're journaling about. Number three, do it daily. And I feel especially when you're starting out, you should be doing it daily, because then you'll start noticing that difference and your brain will slowly start rewiring itself to being grateful for even the smallest things every single day, and you will start looking for things to be grateful for, which is such a beautiful outcome of such a simple practice. So yeah, I think that pretty much covers off how I do my gratitude journaling. I hope that clarified and explained and helped all of you out. Please do give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoy such videos. This was so casual. I haven't shot a video like this on my phone. I've vlogged on my phone definitely, but not like short sit down videos like this. So let me know if you like this really casual vibe, where there's no fancy B-rolls as well. So it's just me sitting here talking to you, giving you as much value as I can from whatever experience I've had. For any more ideas of what all different sort of journal books you can maintain, make sure you watch my notebook collection video. I will link it up here. And also make sure you are following me on my Instagram as well. I'm super active there. I'm posting a lot of dance reels and transition reels, a lot of pictures, a lot of stories behind the scenes, a lot of fun stuff. And that's it. I will see you all in my next video. Till then, stay happy, positive and blessed. Bye. What a wonderful world.